Hey, you kids, get off my lawn. Yeah, that's right. After a lengthy hiatus, it's me, the cranky old man, and this is another edition of Cranky's Corner. And today, we're going to talk about something that's more of a revisit. We're going to talk about something I had almost a year ago, that one of the first Cranky's Corners video. I reviewed the Fuse Vertical Player. That's right, the Fuse Audio Vertical Record Player. And today, I've had it right around a year. So today we're going to find out, did it hold up? Did I throw it in the trash? Let's find out. Got the Cranky Vision on? We're going to go over and we're going to check on this thing. There it is. The Fuse Vertical Record Player, almost a year later. Now, I've used this thing just about every Saturday. This is the song, this is the album I'm listening to, by the way. An old Andrew Sisters. I'm listening to it because A, I like it. And if you don't like the Andrew Sisters, you're hiding under a rock and you should go Google them. Two, maybe they won't copyright strike me this time. I don't know. But I've been using this thing pretty much every weekend and sometimes during the week for almost a year now. And the only upgrade I've made to it was I upgraded the stylus. That's needles to common folks like us. It's an elliptical, and it sounds better. And it'll work for any moving magnetic cartridge, and it's worth the $40 investment. It really is. It makes things sound so much better. This thing has performed incredibly well. I've had no complaints out of it. Well, a couple of observations, but no complaints. In the last year, I've listened to all those, and then there's some 45s around here someplace. I've listened to, God, all sorts of genres. Everything you could possibly think of. I haven't had a problem out of it. I haven't had one record, you know what, I'll take it back. I have had one record skip. And I don't know why. It's a great, great thing. I mean, it's a great album. But it's never skipped on anything else, but it skips on that. But one out of, God, literally hundreds of albums that I've listened to, I'm not going to complain. I've listened to new records, old records, crap records, things I thought would skip and they haven't. All sorts of different genres, just to see if sound vibration might affect anything. Nothing. Everything's been great. I have had one little complaint. This thing has an auto stop on it. And sometimes it works, and sometimes it doesn't. Let's see if we can make it work. Sometimes it stops, and sometimes it don't. Yes, it has a queuing lever. So, let's see. Let's see if it works. Sometimes it's a bit janky. See what I mean? Well, okay, this time it actually stopped. But some records, it'll stop, Then it'll start, then it'll stop, then it'll start. I think it's got something to do with the position of this this label. If the label's not exactly center, it'll if the label's not exactly center, I think it'll keep moving around like that. But that's really the only observation. And it's actually kind of a good thing, because I've had some albums that they seem to run a little long, and on other systems I've had that had the auto stop, it's cut them off, and it's cut the end of the song off before the album was finished. So I kind of like this, so I'm not really complaining about it. The other complaint that I do have, and it's not, again, not a complaint, just an inconvenience. All right. Now, you can see when I take the album off, see that piece of felt behind it? Sometimes that felt tends to fly off with the record and get on the floor. And then you got to bend down and pick it up and dust it off and put it back on. It turns into a thing. So it's an inconvenience. But I'm thinking a piece of tape behind it will fix it. But hey, I'm too lazy for that, and my OCD won't let me put tape on a record player, so I'm not going to do it. That's the magnet I talked about earlier. And I forgot to mention, this is also for 45s. You put the 45 in it, put it on there, and it works good. I've played 45s on it. 45s sound great. 78s sound really good. Well, as good as they could without the proper needle anyway. But they do work. And I do have a bunch of 78 records, or at least my wife does, because she collects them. But anyway, that's Cranky's 1 year revisit of the Fuse Vertical Record Player. It's been a year later. It's still my favorite record player, my main player. I keep it in the main room, and I use it constantly. And until next time, when we find something else to talk about, get off my lawn, listen to your music, and please, please, with all the hate in the world, try and do something nice for your neighbors. Have a great day, guys.